this video, we're going to look at the three factors that control your exposure.
Those three factors work together to form the exposure triangle. Great photography is all about exposure. Exposure is the amount of light that comes through your camera and reaches the sensor to become the image that you create. A photo that has too much light is called overexposed, and a photo that doesn't capture enough light is called underexposed.
The three factors that control your exposure are ISO, aperture value, and shutter speed. By understanding this exposure triangle, you'll have more control over your camera and be ready to take the shots you want. Aperture is the size of the opening within your lens that controls the amount of light that reaches the sensor in the camera. Aperture is measured in f-stops. A larger opening will allow more light through in a given amount of time.
The trade-off of changing your aperture value is that it also impacts your depth of field. A wide-open aperture will let in lots of light, but creates a shallow depth of field within your photo. In contrast, a smaller aperture opening will create a longer depth of field.
The shutter of the camera opens and closes to allow light to reach the sensor. The amount of time that the shutters open is known as shutter speed, and it is measured in fractions of a second. A larger denominator, such as 1 over 2,000 or 1 over 4,000, is a faster shutter speed. A fast shutter speed allows you to stop motion, but it requires a lot of light. A slower shutter speed may introduce motion blur, but it works best in situations where you don't have a lot of light.
The ISO setting tells us the sensitivity level of the sensor. This is controlled within the camera body. A lower ISO setting, such as 200, will give us a photo with much more details. The downside is it takes more light to expose the image. A higher ISO setting, such as 800 or 1600, will give us a better image in low light situations. The downside is we might lose some details or see some noise within our photo. When you're shooting in situations with lots of light, such as afternoon sun or well-lit sporting events, an ISO of 200 or 400 is appropriate. When shooting inside of a classroom or well-lit indoor environments, a 400 or 800 ISO will probably work. When shooting in low-light situations or indoor sports, you may want an ISO as high as 800 or 1600 on your camera. Being able to control your ISO, your aperture value, and your shutter speed will allow you to capture better images. Let's take a look at your camera dial to see how to access those controls.
When shooting in auto mode, the camera controls all three settings. While this may work just fine in some situations, it limits the control you have over your photos.
The next mode that you might use is program mode. Program mode is labeled as a P on the dial of a Canon or a Nikon camera. When shooting in program mode, the photographer has control over the ISO setting, while the camera controls the aperture value and the shutter speed.
Shutter priority mode is marked by a TV on Canon cameras and an S on Nikon cameras. When shooting in shutter priority mode, the photographer controls shutter speed and ISO, while the camera controls aperture.
Aperture priority is the next mode on your dial. This is represented by an A on a Nikon camera, or an AV on a Canon camera. When working in aperture priority mode, the photographer can control the ISO and the aperture setting of the lens while the camera selects the shutter speed.
The last setting on your camera is manual mode. Manual mode is marked by an M on both Nikon and Canon cameras. In manual mode, the photographer decides the settings for aperture, ISO, and shutter speed. This mode is best reserved for more advanced photographers or when you're shooting in a studio setting.
Your camera's dial might have a couple of other modes available, such as landscape, portrait, or sports action, also known as the running man. These modes are simply variations on the auto mode. While they might help in some isolated situations, they don't allow the photographer to take full control over the camera or their images. Working with the exposure triangle and using the different modes on your camera can be very intimidating.
The best way to learn is to practice. Go out every day and practice shooting using these different modes.
And then you'll be ready to capture the best images at every opportunity.